So whenever you edit text in most apps like say TextEdit or Pages, you may have noticed that there are options under Format, Font for Kern, Ligatures, and Baseline. So what do these do? Let's start with taking a look at Kern, and you can see here in TextEdit I've got Default, None, Tighten, and Loosen. So Kern basically is the spacing between characters. So here we've got everything set just as the default. But say I want the spacing to be tighter. I go to Format, Font, Kern, and I can tighten it. Notice that Option, Command, and the left square bracket will tighten it. So you can see it tightens it a little bit. I use the keyboard shortcut and continue to tighten. And then I can use the right bracket to expand. So if I want more spacing between characters, and I want it to be proportional according to the font and things like that so it looks good, I want to use this option here. Now I can go in and set it to the default or none. And in most cases they will be the same thing. Just to get it back to how it was before. So that's Kern. So ligatures actually change how characters look. In order to use them, you need to be using a font that supports them. Sans serif fonts usually don't support them. Sans serif is like this when the lines are straight and there's no special fancy things at the end. A serif font like Times often supports these. And notice here Times does support it, and you can see it in FI and FL, two of the most common ligatures. And notice how they both kind of become one character. So F and I kind of combine together to be one. Let's turn it off to see the difference. So I go to Format, Font, Ligatures, and say Use None. And you can see now F and I and F and L separate. So you have the options here of doing Default, which will use the most common ones, and Use All, which uses some special ones. So if I do Use All, it's not going to make any difference here in Times. But if I go to another font here, you can see I've got FI and FL together, but also ST are together. Now that's kind of an unusual one. And if I were to go to Format, Ligatures, and say Use Default, the S and the T would not be combined in that special character. So you have those options there. And they only come up in fonts like these. Fancy fonts and sometimes scripted fonts as well. And finally that brings us to Baseline. So applying Baseline to a whole bunch of text really doesn't do anything. It will just basically move the text vertically up or down. What you need to do is use it with two characters next to each other where you want things to be a little different. Like for instance in a math formula like x squared I would type x2, but what I really want is the 2 to be superscript. I want it to be up. So I'll go to Font and then I'll go to Baseline and say Use Superscript. And you can see it puts the 2 up on top there. Let's switch back to a regular looking font like that so you can see it more clearly. Now there are differences between how this works based on the app you're using. So let's switch to Pages for instance. And here we'll put X2. Let's make that much larger. So you can see it. And let's switch this to superscript. So I'll go Format, Font, and I will go Baseline and Superscript. And not only will it move the character up, but it actually makes it smaller when you do superscript. So superscript does a couple things. But if I were to go to Baseline and then Raise or Lower, it will just raise it slightly and not change it. And I can keep raising it slightly or lowering it slightly just to move it. Sometimes you want to actually have it be subscript. I'm going to undo that and do subscript there. So you have you know, X prime, for instance, in a math formula. And also note that in Pages, instead of finding Format, Font, and Kerning, you've got character spacing. Does the same thing, just called character spacing in Pages for some reason instead of Kerning.